Hola Barcelona. Namaskar Vanakkam. I'm Namita Marimuthu.
The first ever transgender who's creating a history. That was when, you know, we felt so proud and we just gave our best. She's, you know, adopted around 40 transgenders. Wow. And she's been giving them life and she's been giving education to them, a shelter to them.
It's not only transgenders, we would like to include the LGBT community. Yes.
Welcome to Box Office Entertainments. This is Ashwini and today we have a very special show here to speak about a very special person, Miss Namita Marimuthu. So who is Namita Marimuthu? She is none other than Miss Trans Queen of India, who is currently representing the nation in an international pageant, which is Miss Trans International.
Diversity is a fact. And inclusion is how we deal with it. The 7th largest and the 2nd most populated country in the world, with over 1.37 billion people, India. Representing 29 states and 7 union territories, the biggest democracy in the world. The land of culture, diversity, religious and love. India is a land full of contrast, from the snow-capped peak of the Himalayas, mountain in the north, to the tropical forest of southern India. Hola Barcelona, Namaskar Vanakkam. I'm Namita Marimuthu, a trans model, actress by profession and activist by passion. I hail from a country known for its diverse culture and history, Tamil Nadu. Tamil is one of the longest surviving classical language in the world. My state in southern India, known for its temples, architecture, food, movies, classical Indian dance and Carnatic music. I believe everyone gets a card at the beginning of life. I'm a transgender. I decided to be honest and tell everyone about it. I was trapped until I was 16, and that is when I decided to free myself and had meaning to my life. Indian history is very rich and has numerous mention of trans character in mythology. Despite that, I had my own challenge. I was sent to a mental rehabilitation center and I was stopped connecting to people outside. I was helpless as nobody was able to understand me. I underwent treatment for nothing and one day I just ran away from home. After a legal battle, I got my rights to stay alone as a major and I start to live my dream life. My life-changing event was when I won Miss Trans Queen India, which is first ever pageant for trans women, which itself created by woman Reena Rai, founder of Miss Trans Queen India. Today, I'm standing here as a symbol of inclusive India. A boy who was bringing shame to his parents started expressing herself as a girl to bring pride. I started speaking about my journey, helping my fellow committee members who were waiting for someone to guide them. I started working and gradually also teaching my committee friends to help them lead a life of dignity as who they are. Today, I have more than 40 transgenders who call me as a mom. I have a big family now. Life has changed and uploading me and my work. My parents also accepted me. They have realized that what they did was wrong and admit the independent Namita who are extremely proud of now. If I become Miss Trans Star International, I am optimistic enough that I'll be able to break the barriers we have around the gender, sex and sexuality. I will make people aware and populate the idea of co-extensions with acceptance of diversity around us, using my communication as a tool for change. To eradicate transphobia, there is a need to make trans visible and showcase the work we are doing without any excuses. I, along with my brothers and sisters from across the globe, will begin a journey to create awareness through education, digital media, and start dialoguing with the society and to foster inclusivity and diversity all across. My aim will remain to create an equal society, sans judgment of any form. I'm so fortunate to have lived with this cross of high and low, and even prouder to made myself capable enough to represent India today at such a big platform. I'm Namita Marimuthu. I'm extremely excited to begin my journey at Miss Trans Star International and bring glory to just not my country, but to all the transgenders and brothers around the world. Namaskar.
So right now we are at Niralia Studios, who is a wardrobe sponsor for Namita at this event, and we are going to meet Ranjita Sundar, who is the founder of the studio. At Niralia Studios and have Ranjita Sundar and Apurva Ravi with me. So welcome you both to Box Office Entertainments. It's a pleasure having you both here. So Ranjita, tell me something about yourself and your studio. Yeah.
Okay.
First of all, it's a beautiful studio, so congratulations
on
that.
Thank you so much. That's very sweet of you. And yes, this is Ranjita Sundar, celebrity fashion designer and stylist. I've worked for almost 8 movies as a celebrity designer and stylist. And I've done one Hollywood movie, and I've basically from Bangalore, but my designs have gone all over the world. I've got clients from US, UK, and Malaysia, Singapore, Sri Lanka, name it, and it would have been gone there. And yes, finally I'm here designing for international pageants and international shows. I currently hold a title, I am the director for Beautiful You Fashion Tour. That's an international fashion show. And yeah, I've landed up here having my own set of cozy studio for myself.
And that's very inspiring, and congratulations on achieving so much of success at this age. So tell us something about Apurva here.
Okay, what do I tell about Apurva? Apurva Ravi is my co-designer. We've been doing all the projects together. So we almost have the same line of achievements and projects in hand. She's always been there.
Okay.
You know, she's the main designer head for Niralia Studios. So that's about Apurva, and she's best. She's won best designer award in JD Institute. Best unique collections, and both of us have the same kind of a purpose in life. We feel serving transgenders and getting their talent to the world is the main purpose of life, and that's why we are here today.
That's great. When you talk about fashion, usually people will go, well, the mainstream line is fashion models, maybe it's female or male. So why transgenders? What is your story behind it?
Okay, why transgenders? That's a bit, you know, I have to take you back maybe 6 years flashback.
Okay.
So that was when I did my final year designing in Mount Carmel College. So I am a degree holder in fashion designing. So there's something called portfolio, which all the designers do. So when my teachers, they said you have to do some collections, and everyone in my class came up, I'll do it for kids, I'll do it for ladies, I'll do it for men, and some were telling, a mix of, for brides and grooms. So that's when I got an idea, there's a third community as well, you know, it's just not the world, and the fashion especially is not only for women and men and kids.
Sure.
It's even for the third gender, and that's when I came up with an idea. I said I want to do a collections for transgenders, and I don't feel sorry to tell it. It was definitely my teachers and college, they were against it because my college is run by nuns, and not even boys were allowed because it's a girls' college. And so getting a transgender model was a bit challenging. But I told them either I do transgender designing or I'll not do anything.
Okay.
So. And I was good at studies, and I used to represent my college in a very big stages, and I, you know, they thought I was a little pride for my college, so they agreed. They said, okay, this is, you know, this girl is some up to something, and there you go, you just go do what you want. And later, it was that first stage itself was a little challenging for me to get the approval from the college. And the second challenge was, now where do I go for transgender models? So that was a very big question, and my family, my dad, literally me and my dad, we've roamed everywhere, like, you know, literally mm-hmm. standing in every signals and trying to console them,
mm-hmm.
trying to tell them this is for you, and we've been trying to get you out from, you know, particular one, you know, kind of a circle what you've
sure.
drawn,
mm-hmm.
and so it was a little difficult task, but I achieved. Yes, I did get some transgender models. I groomed them, I styled them, I kind of, you know, made them a little different person, and I probably gave them a lot of confidence in them, and they also adapted that so quickly, actually.
Mm-hmm.
And they did my show, and when I did the show, my jury was a little shocked.
Mm-hmm.
They said, your portfolio says you're doing it for transgender, but then we don't see any transgender on stage.
Okay.
So that was the first level of success which I met, because, and then later I told my juries, whoever you see here are all transgenders. So I've not come here to change anything in them, but want to change the people's, you know, the so-called men and women and normal people's vision on them. So
the social stigma.
Yes. So
them.
They were awestruck. They said, okay, this is something very new. I mean, probably six years back, it was very competing, you know, that's it was very challenging for grooming a transgender and designing for them, because designing for a normal model is fine because they have, you know, the same structures and the normal measurements and all that. But for designing a transgender, it was different. They have a very masculine body and
mm-hmm.
then a bust and then, you know, a little different thing.
Yeah.
So I had to do a little research on that.
Okay.
But still, it was fun, you know. I was doing it with so much of satisfaction. So that's when I thought, you know, if I'm doing something in life and if I want to hail as a designer, so I just want to do a little different things for that particular community.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I get to introduce one more designer with me. This is my co-designer, as I told you. She also did the same, you know, in her college.
Yeah,
so, Apu, I think you should be able to tell your experience and about
share
your
story as well.
Yeah, but my story is not as difficult as yours. It was 6 years back. But recently, I did a show for
mm-hmm.
JD. I walked the ramp
mm-hmm.
and my collection is entirely different.
Mm-hmm.
I think it would be a surprising moment when people would hear about it.
Okay.
It's something which is related to transgenders
mm-hmm.
but in a different art form.
Okay.
So there's a group of people called Arvani Art Project. I think you people would have come across. There's this
mm-hmm.
transgender community.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So they generally, they don't stand on signals. They're not somewhere like that.
Mm-hmm.
There's a group of people.
Mm-hmm.
They paint walls, the abandoned
okay.
walls. Wherever you find in Bangalore,
okay.
you find they paint them, they have a message like trans
mm-hmm.
rights are human rights, equal rights.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So my collection was inspired by them. So
okay.
I had to go talk to them, convince them, and I asked them, can you please come paint my garments? So my entire collection was about them, and whatever prints you can see on my collection was painted,
mm-hmm.
everything was painted by transgenders.
Mm-hmm.
So this is how I ended up, and luckily one more thing which happened was my collection got selected for Bangalore Times Fashion Week.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And simultaneously the Pride Month was happening for the LGBT community.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So it was on June 1st, and here comes a big story, and that is when I met Namita Marimutto. So she was my model.
Okay.
She was one of the models for my collection, and that is when I got connected with her.
Okay.
And it's reached up to Niralia Studios today.
Wow.
So that is how we got introduced.
I think both of your works has been commendable. And so let's talk about Namita right now. So you said you got to know her through her. So how has the journey been so far after you met her, and how she's gone from model from India representing a country in an international pageant? How did this all go about, or how do you know much about her journey in this?
Okay. So Namita is very sweet person, basically, you know. They're not like, you know, the very that kind of attitude and all that. She's a supermodel though. She's done very big fashion shows like Bangalore Times Fashion Show, Bangalore Week Fashion Show, and you know, everything. So, but when Apu, you know, when she came up and said, Ranj, there's this model of mine, you know, who's been selected to world stage, and this is the first time an Indian transgender who's been going, can we sponsor, you know, can Niralia Studios be a sponsor for their,
mm-hmm.
you know, pageant dresses? I don't think I had a second thought about it. I said, why not? We're doing it for so many people who are capable of, you know, earning it. But for doing it for them is what we have been striving for since ages. So I said, definitely, yes, we will go for it. And then we met Namita.
Mm-hmm.
She had come to Bangalore. Basically, she's from Chennai.
Okay.
So she's a Chennai person. So she came down to Bangalore and we discussed how things has to go on, and she was literally very happy because in a small interview some media person had actually questioned her, telling who would support you know, a person like you, like basically a transgender who's going, don't you feel you know, it's a little overconfident you feel about yourself and your journey. She just gave them only one word. She said, you know, when there is a female who's going, you know, international, there's your entire nation supports them, but there would be someone, you know, in the same country to support us. If I meet them, definitely I'll, you know, I'll get them to you. So that's how she promised, and the next day immediately we agreed, and she was so happy. She said, probably God has heard my prayers and I'm so happy to connect you guys, and you know, that's how it started. So designing for her was, I'll not tell it was, you know, such a stress or anything, because we did it out of our heart and
fashion,
soul, and you know,
we gave
you know, the best, and because every minute or every design or every sketch when we sat and did, it was just that, you know, she's the pride of our country.
Definitely.
So, you know, normal girls, they've gone, so many people have gone from India and so many people do so many things. But when it comes to the first ever transgender who's creating a history, that was when, you know, we felt so proud and we just gave our best. So
Ranjita, tell us, what are the challenges you face while designing for Namita?
Okay. I would not tell it was a challenge for me. It was quite smooth. But what I would like to tell is, there's almost 36, you know, countries which has been taking part in Miss Transstar International pageant. So a lot of people from different countries like US, Switzerland, Mexico,
Mauritius,
Thailand, and you know, a lot. But the pride and the happiest thing is Namita is the tallest among everyone. She's almost 6'2" natural height. So with heels, she would definitely be around 6'7", if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, 6'7".
So basically what happened was, you know, she's basically very tall. So while taking measurements and, you know, when we are doing her designs, and you know, when she stands, I literally have to go on top of a chair and then take measurements, and the tape would be over and I'm like, Namita, you're tall, and she's like, I'm sorry, baby. And you know, that all that is not challenge, but it's very, you know, nice. And half of the time we were requesting our master, telling, you know, it was so hard for us to make them believe that is the natural height, and you know, make it a little long. So they'll tell, no, this is very long, this is very long, kind of a thing. But it was fun, it was very fun. But last, when I think the most challenging task was, I had to deliver her national costume.
Yeah.
So totally we have done a lot of costumes for her, but majorly it is the main thing was national costume, where we kept the theme as peacock, as it's the national bird. And why peacock for this particular pageant was because basically many people think, you know, peacock is a female, but actually it's a male, which is so beautiful. So that was a, you know, collab and connection what we tried giving. And we did a wonderful, you know, heavy lehenga for her with all peacock embroidery over it. And we gave her nice accessories, and we had something different, not like a normal national costume. So we gave her like, you know, bizarre kind of a shoulder piece, you know, and which has a peacock feathers and all that. So what happened was, you know, it was, you know, as the time was pressing, national costume I had to carry. So I had to, because I didn't want to give it to anyone or put in any kind of a courier. So night she had the flight, I think by 2 o'clock, and she had to go check in by 11 o'clock. But that particular day I had some commitment, and not me, my husband had a commitment. So from Bangalore to Chennai, we left Bangalore only by 4. So we literally had to rush to the airport. We went from not even one single stop, like not even for food, you know. He just like, no, it's very late and we have to zoom up. So we took the car, I think around 4, and we reached the airport, I think by 10:30.
Okay.
So luckily, you know, it was on time. So I took another, you know, we had a little press meet over there, and I was able to join the press meet as well. And I was so happy among so many transgender who had come to send her off. I was the only female friend of hers who went as a friend, you know, who went there to send her off. So that was very, you know, unique, and that was, she felt so happy about it.
And also, as you said, you were the only single female giving her a send-off there. And I really hope that changes. Probably when she comes back, I hope there's a lot of people more waiting to receive her. I hope that at least changes in this short period of time. And the other question that I have for you is, what are your future goals? So something different, what is some? What do you want to do more about maybe transgenders or a different community? Do you have such plans?
Yes, of course, you know, we have come this far, probably we have set a benchmark for our own.
Yes.
So we will not stop doing things for transgenders. Our future goals and plans for that particular community is, we for Nirulya Studios, we are planning for a mass production.
Mm-hmm.
And we would like to employ only transgenders for the production team. Like, you know, we want to train them for design, being a designers. We want to train them to do RE work, embroidery work, and some of the hand-painted stuffs. We want to, encourage their talent, and we will find out what exactly they are good at, and we will try improving that a bit, and then convert that talent into a product. Sell it and give whatever, you know, comes.
It belongs to them.
It belongs to them. So that's the biggest dream what we have.
Yeah.
So, and apart from that, yes, we are planning for a lot of international shows for them.
Okay.
And a small, you know, fashion studio to train transgender models.
Yes. Okay.
And to train them. Basically to train them what they are interested in the field of fashion. So that's what we are,
yeah, to put them
on
the limelight.
Yeah.
And one more thing, it's not only transgenders, we would like to include the LGBT community.
Yes.
So
mm-hmm.
even though right now the transgenders are coming out of their you know, the shadows, whatever you mentioned.
Correct.
Earlier, but I really want the LGBT community to even come out.
Mm-hmm.
In India. So it's like break the taboo.
Yeah.
So something like that.
I think we should all break the taboo.
Yeah, we should all.
Yes. That's the
so
journey.
As you just heard, so we have the pride of the nation representing us in an international pageant. So this is all of us, Ranjita, Apurva, and the entire team of Box Office Entertainments who are in support of Namita. And I'm sure there's a whole lot of people out there in the nation who do not know about this, but when they do, they're all there to support her and encourage her, and we want more of them, transgenders, coming out and proving themselves and getting all the glory to our nation and to their community. So is there anything else you'd like to tell the people in general about transgenders, or how they must encourage them, and how there are people, many like Namita, who needs their support and encouragement? Any few words about them?
Yes, I think definitely, you know, over the age, you know, over the time, since, you know, since 6 years, as I know, there's a lot of difference and a lot of improvement for that particular community. But I would tell, it is not enough, you know, it is definitely not enough. And about Namita, I would like to tell, you know, she's not only representing India. You know, she's not only creating history, personally, she's a very good-hearted,
mm-hmm.
you know, person. She is, you know, it's very surprising maybe. She's, you know, adopted around 40 transgenders,
mm-hmm.
And she's been giving them life, and she's been giving education to them, a shelter to them, and she's been, you know, making the community so strong that they are not only meant for, you know, standing in the signals or getting into the wrong businesses, but she's training them and, you know, counseling them, educating them on different fields. She's been sponsoring for so many transgenders for their education, and she's actually reunited almost 25 transgenders to their family, I think, which is at most important when it comes to the transgender community. The family itself don't accept, you know, that's the most saddest part. But Namita is our family. She's one of our family members. And not only Namita, I work with a lot of transgenders. And I've come across a lot of stories. And, you know, I don't tell them they are my friends or they are my model. I just address them as they are my family. Because their own family, they don't accept them. And which is the most saddest thing which is happening right now. I think when the families start accepting them, the whole ball game will change. So that's the first thing which Indian family should, you know, inculcate.
Definitely,
so that's the only thing which is still, you know, saddening. So you have something?
Yeah, I would like to tell something. When I was doing my collection, I had to go through a lot of history, myth, scriptures. And I came up with the Vedic culture of India. That's one of the old scriptures in India. And that thing surprised me, where I learned that men, women, transgenders had equal rights in that period. The old scriptures says all about it. So as we come through our current situation, when the world is moving forward, the India is moving forward, but why are they lacking when it comes to this community? So that is when I decided, why don't we bring out people? See, first of all, they are among us, human beings. And they hide themselves because of the way people treat them. Their own parents abandon them.
Yeah, true.
So that is the main reason why I came up with this concept. I found the Arvani Art Project people. And believe me, today when they leave their home, people would ask them, they would come and talk to them, ask them, today where are you painting? Rather than avoiding them, that's not the thing. So I would like to bring the change among other transgenders who are left behind. So this is what is our focus.
So right now we have the Future India here, who want to bring about the change that is very much necessary in this country and all over the world. So what we need right now is awareness about them and support for them and basic empathy towards them, and not treat them as something different or as untouchables, because they are one among us. If you have the right, they have the right too. So Ranjita, now I'm sure there are a lot of us out there who want to support people like Namita, but who are not aware or who do not know how to show their support. So for people like them, tell us how right now we can support Namita. What can we do?
Okay. So if you want to support Namita Marimuthu, and if you think she's the pride of our country, please support her by liking the Facebook and Instagram page Miss Trans Star International. There is a poster of Namita. So you just have to go there, like her poster, comment how many ever comments you want, and share the post throughout and make your friends do the same. Thank you so much.
So with that note, I thank you both again for joining us today, and it was a pleasure meeting you and talking about Namita. So there you go, Namita. You have a lot of people here behind you, supporting you and encouraging you and looking up to you. So let's bring about this awareness and let's create more of such empathy towards them, and let's encourage them to whatever extent we can. And I'm sure they will go places and make us proud.